Come here, Emilio.
And this is what
he does going love crazy right now.
God thinks that Job is behaving just wonderfully. Satan doesn't buy it and says, of course he's being good. You've given him everything. Let's take some things away and see what happens. This finally is the full-blown Satan as the accuser and the one who works evil against good people.
God allowed Satan to torment Job, to afflict him with painful boils, to destroy his property, and then to kill his children, all to see if Job would renounce God. Satan is quoted in the book of Job saying, in the end, a man will give all he has in exchange for his own life. Job nearly broke under the pressure. For a moment, he doubted God's love for him. But he quickly realized his error and reaffirmed his faith. According to the Bible, Job lived to be 140 years old. Satan had failed in his assault upon the faithful Job. But he was undeterred in his crusade of evil. He inflicted death and destruction on man as often.
Hi, Max. Oh, we're looking for you. Good morning, Max. Hi.
But Satan was about to meet a person like none other he had encountered.
Hi.
One who would require his most fervent attention.
You were asleep all this time. Go check out the warty pumpkin.
Despite occasional setbacks, ugly, huh? With Job, Satan held
it's an ugly pumpkin.
Demonic grip on the ancient world.
Give it a good sniffing.
In one form or another, he became a fixture in religions that desperately searched for ways to explain the existence of evil.
Smell it. Came from Gilroy.
Ancient people didn't have porch lights, didn't have street lights. They were afraid of the darkness because awful things could happen to you. Wild animals could eat you. Demons could come up out of cracks in the earth and afflict you with all sorts of diseases.
Dude,
so it was now.